So, first of all, what is Ubuntu? Ubuntu is a distribution of the GNU plus Linux system. There are over 1,000 distributions, variants of the GNU slash Linux system. Ubuntu is one of them. Most of these distributions have ethical flaws. For instance, most of them contain some non-free software. Effectively, they say their priority is not your freedom, it's just convenience. So if you install one of those non-free distros, well, you're closer to freedom than if you ran Windows or some Apple system, but you're not all the way there. But even worse, because they present convenience rather than freedom as their goal, they're teaching people not to value freedom. And by doing that, they're doing a deep form of harm to our whole community. Ubuntu is one of them. It's a variant of GNU slash Linux that installs various non-free programs and proposes even more. But Ubuntu has an unusual flaw too, which is its spyware, malicious functionalities to do things like spy on the user. Well, those are typically found in proprietary software. They're rare in free software, but Ubuntu is one example. Ubuntu has a desktop feature to search for something, and they're trying to make it an all-purpose, convenient way of searching for things. And when the user searches this way, it sends the user's search terms to Canonical, the company that makes and distributes Ubuntu. And this already is spyware. You know, when you search for something, it shouldn't by default send anything to a company. That should be something you do optionally, knowing you're doing it each time, so that you think about, do I want to show somebody else that I'm looking for this, or do I just want to look in my own computer? In any case, what Canonical does is Canonical has a list of Amazon products, and it sees which Amazon products relate to those search terms, and it tells Amazon to display ads for those products on the user's computer. And since Amazon is sending those ads directly to the user's computer, Amazon gets to find out something about that user too. Namely, that user was sent these ads, probably the user was searching for such and such. This is egregious. And we need to teach Canonical a lesson. We need to teach Canonical not to spy on its users. He had to apologize for calling me childish because people jumped on him for that.
His black dog was
But
full of it.
yeah, the point is that they didn't apologize for spying on users. Of course not. That was a business decision. And unless we push them hard, they won't change it and they won't apologize for it. Actually, I'm more concerned with whether they change it than whether they apologize for it. You know, I'm not so much interested in making them eat crow as in making them stop. Because one of the advantages that we cite for free software is the users can protect themselves from malicious features. And we can protect ourselves from malicious features in Ubuntu by changing it, by making a modified version which doesn't spy. And there already are modified versions that don't spy. But the point is, what we really want to be able to say to people is the dissuasive force, the deterrent force of the community's rejection of malicious functionalities is so strong that you can be pretty confident that it won't even try to spy on you. And to recover that, we've got to convince the Ubuntu developers to stop spying. That's why this issue is important. Of course, they will try to spin it a different way based on different values. They say, convenience above all. Look at the convenience we're giving you. And by the way, Amazon will give us some money and we could use that to write some free programs, which in and of itself is good, but doesn't justify perverting free software. I mean, it doesn't justify something egregious. So they've got to stop it. Now, as for putting Ubuntu GNU/Linux in phones, well, I don't know what those are going to do. Maybe they'll have the same spyware feature. I suppose they probably will. But we'll see what the facts are. I also expect that they will contain non-free programs.